Good guys, my name is Lord Tomo. Welcome again to another Sonic the Hedgehog Toy Item Collector Review. As you know, I'm Lord Tomo with the good old British Test Sonic the Hedgehog. Put him aside because I want to get into this review so badly because I love it so much. This is Rouge the Bat. Now, for those who may or may not know, this is obviously Rouge the Bat, as I previously mentioned. But essentially, she's a character design that was first appeared in Sonic Adventure 2, for those who may or may not know. She has made other cameos and she was playable in several games such as the likes of Sonic Heroes. Now, I really wanted the plush that expands the universe beyond the obligatory Sonic, Knuckles, Tails, and Dr. Eggman, and whatnot. And the company that has done this and will continue to do this, and I hope they continue to do this, is none other than GE Great Eastern Entertainment, which I will show you the tag itself. Now, this company, if they even bother to check out this review or whatnot, they essentially are the pioneers, in my honest opinion, of the new creation of phenomenal, exceptional plushie designs of the Sonic series, of course, and various other ones. And this one is obviously no exception, definitely no exception to it. I'm going to go straight into, there's a few hiccups. By hiccups I mean it's not bad, but some more nitpicks that I personally have from this plush line itself. It's something that I would rather, you know, it change slightly. It doesn't detract or deter from the actual plush itself and whatnot. So we'll go through this as the review itself. The first thing and foremost, they do phenomenal, and this has always been a massive, you know, criticism I have, is the hashtag here, or the little, the tag, or whatever you like to call it. I'm going to just call it a tag. It's located, you know, it needs to be located somewhere, so it was on the hip. But what they've always done is they always add the cardboard piece on like some obscure place, like some brands would have in the ear or their arms, or just something that just completely detracts from the actual plush line itself. GE, obviously, they must have heard it from fans, or they themselves decided this, but they always put this card on the actual tag itself, which I think is great because you can put it anywhere and it does not detract from the actual plush itself. And also for collectors like myself and various other peoples, they like to keep it as minimal as humanly possible, which is always a plus. The small nitpick that I do have for this, regretfully, is the actual card itself. Now, it's a Sonic the Hedgehog plush. Technically, this isn't Sonic the Hedgehog. She is part of the universe of Sonic the Hedgehog, but she isn't obviously Sonic the Hedgehog. She is Rouge the Bat, of course, as many of people may know. Now, my only guess as to why they would basically have that is simply to attract newer fans, newer people that may not know anything about the canon expansion or the universe beyond Sonic the Hedgehog themselves. So if somebody was to see this in a store and say, oh look, it's Sonic the Hedgehog, it's a bat, I wonder who she is, and they start to investigate more into it, that is probably the only main reason I would think they would have this picture there. I could be wrong. I'm sure there's many other reasons why they did it, but it is what it is. At the back you have its logo, which is GE Entertainment, Great Eastern Entertainment, awesome company. They have I would probably argue that they are the pioneers of creating some of the most phenomenal, exceptional plushies out there in the series of Sonic the Hedgehog, and they do various other ones. I think they do Naruto as well. Very great company. The second thing I'd like to mention is, of course, you have a little, you know, hook where you can hang it up. It's not necessarily needed, but it's there. If you want to remove it, I guess you could actually cut it. It's totally up to you. I'm going to leave it as is. The actual head itself is extremely well stuffed. The whole body itself is extremely well stuffed. Now, there are some plushies out there which I'll probably use this as an example, where the actual shoulder is only, oh not shoulder, I'll show you here, where the actual arm itself is pretty moderately well stuffed, but you have like this little concave area, this little area where it's not, and it doesn't give that its fullest. It kind of looks, dare I say, pretty stupid, right? But this one, it's well stuffed everywhere, which is awesome. I love how they did that. So the whole head, the arms, the legs, the feet, the tails, everything is phenomenal. I also like, if you look closely here, you actually see the inlining of the actual ear itself, and real seamless stitching. Of course you can see the stitching, but it blends in so well. They also done something which, it's just the small things, attention to the details. Now in the game, comics and whatnot, her ears, or I like to say her ears, actually forms kind of like a concave effect, kind of like blends in seamlessly, and they actually done it there. You can actually see from the top up here how they basically, it was meant to be, it's one piece, but they just stitched it over just to give that added fullness and added effect. which I think is phenomenal, just the level of attention to detail this actually has. Of course, you know, it's each design is different, but great nonetheless. I wouldn't say this is a nitpick, but I'm always hesitant about this simply because of the way people touch it and hold it and whatnot. Now, the actual eyes and mouth, as far as I'm aware, have ironed on stickers to give it that detail, which isn't necessarily bad. It's awesome, quite honestly. It's just, as someone who likes to handle around their stuff around, you know, I worry that it's probably gonna have wear and tear and slowly remove out. So the eyes are extremely straight tuned, or extremely phenomenal to that of the actual gaming comic, which is awesome. And of course you have a suggestive little, you know, her smile and her lip bar and whatnot, which is awesome. There's a nose bun, it's there. Now at the back you have her little, I don't know what they are, hairline quills. It's definitely not quills, it's the back part of her hair, I guess. I know from the top of my head, but I just can't pick it up. But I'm just gonna say this is just her bottom half of the hair. Extremely well done. Once again, I didn't have to add the extra fullness, but they did. Great. Now, what really technically blew me away was her actual wings. Now, her wings have this symmetrical kind of bat-like effect, as in, you can see how it can technically expand and so she can fly and whatnot. I guess you could add a level of customization by flipping them over and putting them in front of her little hair quills and whatnot. I probably will, just for the sake of it, so it gives it kind of this whole mysterious look to it, or you can just flip them back and have them there. Now they are attached to the back of the ear, so if you wanted to, you could technically cut it off and make it more, you know, flimsical or more movable. Totally up to you. I'm not necessarily needed, simply because you can't pose it much more. The material itself is well done, but I've noticed that as well, they have like this kind of metallic this metal bar of sorts. I wouldn't say bar, this metal kind of paper all these words are slipping out of my mouth incorrectly. Kind of like this little small metal bar that basically goes through the actual wings itself, which gives it that more 3D-esque sort of vibe to it, which basically, as you can tell, goes all the way up there and bends over. So it's just one piece of metal which basically bends over and forms the actual more prominent wings, which I think is awesome. It's just this small attention to detail that I find great. Now there's a, this looks weird on mine, I'm guessing it's just, it is what it is, but I think it adds character to her. She's got a love heart chest piece which kind of looks like half of it is covering and the other half is slipping down, kind of giving this whole, you know, ooh la la sort of effect. It works because she is very seductress in terms of her characteristics. Arms, great, as you would expect, typical. Of course, it's stuck to its typical stitching where it's basically one piece, but they stitched it over to give the fingers. I have no issue with that. I think it's well done. And if you look at it further, you have a shoe effect. Once again, extremely well done. The love hearts and whatnot, they even went out of their ways to basically give it a that just makes it look okay. Kind of gives it this heel-like effect, exactly like the actual games and comics and whatnot. So you can see how it basically would look if she's basically, that's a bad side image. Basically looks like exactly this game from the actual side. And you can see a little tail there, front, and of course back. So there's so much detail to this actual approach itself. It's literally words escape me in terms of how great this basically looks. And I think this is definitely something for those of you who want to consider collecting this. Definitely pick this up. It's definitely worth its weight in gold. I got this roughly for about $20. I think the big one costs a little more. Is it worth its money? Definitely pick it up. If you definitely want to, you know, collect variations of the universe other than Sonic, Tails, Knuckles, and Dr. Eggman or Robotnik, definitely pick this up. It's definitely on eBay. That's all I saw. I couldn't find it in my store. I haven't checked all my stores, but there used to be a store that does sell a lot of Sonic stuff. Unfortunately, they don't. Bummer. But yeah, $20. Definitely on eBay. That's where I got this one in particular and various other ones as well. And it's rarity. It's 1/10. It's definitely common. It's not maybe rare in the future. Maybe not. I'm not 100% sure. but it's definitely, you can't go wrong. It works so well without the other plushies in terms of actual length, provided this is a pretty fat ass Sonic the Hedgehog. But yeah, worth sculpt and whatnot. Those are the real, I can't praise this enough. I generally can't. It is an awesome design, and to say otherwise would be an absolute lie. Anyway, guys, tell me what you think. Do you hate it? Do you like it? Is it something you would necessarily pick up? Is it something you would want? Who knows? Anyway, guys, thank you so much for checking out this review. Speed on, take care. Until next time, peace.